That's crazy. Yo, what's going on, guys? Bobby here, and today we are back with a very unique video. So today, we have two brawlers that are just above and beyond the rest. They are the absolute two most overpowered brawlers in the game, and they're actually the two newest brawlers that just came out. We have Byron and Edgar. Now, these brawlers are both very OP, but very different and very unique in their own ways. We're going to be covering both brawlers, what they're good at, what they're bad at, and at the end of the video, I'm going to give my opinion for what I think is the best brawler in the game. Now, this is a really unique situation because usually we know exactly which brawler is the best, the second best, the third best, etc. But these two brawlers are basically even in my opinion, and in most people's opinions, there's huge debates going on about what brawlers are better. I would like to know your opinion, so let me know in the comment section below what you guys think. But with that being said, we're going to hop into some games. We're going to show you guys what is so good about each brawler. We're going to talk about what the weakness is for each brawler and tell you guys what we think is going to go down. So let's hop into it. Okay, so for all the games that we're going to be showing you guys today, it's going to be at around 1,000 trophies plus for our gameplay on ladder. So we're gonna be showing you guys Byron to start off. So what Byron is really good at is control and healing, obviously. So Byron obviously doesn't have the highest DPS per second. It doesn't do insane damage, but what it does is it slowly chips away at brawlers very easily over time. Additionally, what you have is your gadget, which is really good for healing yourself. I'm kind of taking it to an extreme up there, kind of limit testing, seeing how far I can go. We still end up getting the kill. And you can also obviously heal your teammates. Now, how much damage does Byron do? How much healing does Byron do? You guys already know this. I don't want to be like a broken record and sound like every single YouTuber that's ever made a video on these brawlers. But you guys know it does a little bit more than 1600 attack and 1600 per heal. It hits for 560 base damage and then does two more ticks after that. So it does really good heal and really good damage. So why is Byron broken in modes like Gem Grab? Because Gem is all about control. It's all about sustaining pressure. It's all about just having yourself on the gem mine, just constantly picking up gems, winning lanes. And there is no brawler that's better at just forcing pressure and consistently being up there than Byron. If you have a Pam mid, for example, all you have to do is continuously shoot your Pam mid and your Pam mid will not go down. Constant pressure. No one will ever be able to move up on you. And then your lane, it's super hard to kill you because of the fact that you're so long range, you can just poke at them. We got really easy star player there, really easy win. Let's hop into the next game and let's keep going. Additionally, with Byron, the heal is super good. We're going up against three really good players here. I know them all personally. Shout out to these three guys. But Byron is super good, obviously, at mid. It's clearly the best mid on this map, and we haven't even done too many games here. Edgar is going to jump on Sam. That's usually a really easy kill for the Edgar, but we have our super. It's able to do damage to them and heal us at the same time. So you also get really high value super sometimes. I would have gone down over there, but I just simply click the gadget button. And it's just going to be really easy for us to get really sustainable, easy work on these guys. Going to be able to kill the Edgar over there. Sam should be able to score. Unfortunately for us, we kind of screwed that one up. But Sam's going to be able to get the kill, and we're going to get really good pressure. Now, this game isn't so much about showing you guys the actual game, but we want to show you guys how good Byron is at actually countering plays that should be easy kills. So, for example, you guys are going to see Slights. He's going to jump on us or a little bit later into the game, and you guys are going to see he's not going to be able to get the kill. Why? Because Byron has really good healing, fairly good damage as well, and is a really good brawler. Do not pay attention to what I just did right there and missing my super. But anyways, it is really good. You guys are going to see over here, he's going to try and jump on Sam again, try and do some damage. But I have my super. I'm going to throw it right on Sam, right on Sights. And Sam is almost full HP. The Edgar is dead from just one Byron super. So Byron is really good from that point of view. You also have the gadget again. I should have gone down over there, but the gadget is going to keep me alive and basically get me to full health. And it only costs one ammo slot, so it doesn't really do that much, doesn't cost that much. And you actually heal over time. Now, what's actually really good about Byron and what I think is really underrated is the fact that it doesn't do 1500 to 1600, whatever the exact amount of damage it is, at 1 second. But in fact, it does it over time. It doing it over time essentially just means that you're not going to be able to get that kill or straight away, but the other player isn't going to be able to regen sooner. So if it takes 2 seconds for all the hits to go down, it's going to be 2 more seconds that they have to back away from the fight in order for you to get the kill. Byron, again, really good at just sustaining pressure, really good at that mid-range poke, really good at that healing, and is just a very, very good brawler all around. With that being said, we're going to hop over to Edgar, and we're going to show you guys why Edgar is super OP. Okay, so now getting into Edgar, there is a really, clear and obvious reason for why this brawler is broken, and you guys are going to see it in about 5 seconds here. As soon as Edgar gets its super, about 30% of the brawlers can kill it. Besides that, it is a free kill every single time. Edgar dominates every single brawler that it counters. Once you get that super, it is basically over for the other team, and the three gadgets make it so essentially you have three guaranteed supers. As you guys see, I can jump on that mic, get that really easy kill. You have that additional speed, so we're able to take out that Nita really well as well. In my opinion, Heist is probably the best mode for Edgar. Now, I'm not 100% sure yet. We haven't done everything. We haven't done an insane amount of testing. We've only had about half a day here in North America. But as you guys can tell from me being on the safe, doing tons of damage, able to take out multiple brawlers, it is a very, very good brawler in Heist. And it usually counters the Heist meta. So what are you going to be facing in Heist? You're going to be facing squishy such as Colt, Brock, Rico, Mike, Barley, and just brawlers that you can jump on with Edgar and completely destroy. Now, with that being said, Edgar does have a downside. We're going to get into that a little bit later. But if I were you guys and I wanted to push Edgar, I would do it in Brawl Ball or in Heist, where you just completely dominate, as you guys can see from this game. Let's hop into the next one and let's keep talking Edgar. So with Edgar, there's a couple things that you can do and a couple things that you definitely can't do. So obviously the downside to Edgar is you have 4,200 health. Now, this is not a lot. This is actually on the more squishy side. And the fact that you have the lowest range, or the shortest, I should say, range in the game mixed with this HP is actually very interesting. Now, if you're facing smart players, you're not going to be able to just run around and team wipe, which you can definitely do with this brawler if you're playing the right comp. If you're playing with a Poco or with a Max or a Byron, Edgar is a very fierce brawler. But alone, you can't really run around and just kill everyone. You can usually get one kill at a time. If I were you and I was playing Edgar, what I would do is I would try and single out someone, wait till they're all alone, and that's when I would make my move. I wouldn't jump on groups of people because, again, that low HP, you just die so easily, as you guys can see. If you just jump in with low HP, you're not going to kill people. If you just jump in on two people, you're not going to get that kill. You have to single out one person and get a kill alone. You guys can see exactly what their Edgar is doing. I'm just trying to figure out exactly what is OP with Edgar right now. So I jump in. I try and jump not directly on someone and see how that goes. I get stunned and I go down immediately. Edgar isn't really totally broken, but I think at times and in a lot of situations, it is the best brawler in the game. So what does that mean for the overall? Who is better between Edgar and Byron? I think Byron personally is better because Byron, no matter what the situation and no matter what is going on, Byron is going to be pretty OP. Now, they both do have their downsides. So although I said no matter what situation, there is a couple of very rare situations, such as when you're facing like a Poco double tank and you're the only one alive and you need to be able to make a save. You're not going to be able to make the save. You're not going to be able to 1v3 because you just don't do enough damage and you don't do enough immediate damage. Additionally, with Byron, it's just work over time, so it doesn't look too OP. You're not going to get those insane clips like you can with other brawlers, maybe such as Edgar. But with Edgar, it's the exact opposite of Byron that makes it OP. It lacks that consistency. It's not so good over the course of the game, but there are going to be moments where you can just completely team wipe, even though you're not usually going to be able to. I'm sure sometimes you're going to be able to get some wild team wipe. It's the consistency that lacks. So you have one brawler, which is really good always, but isn't, you know, super overpowered at its peak, and then you have one brawler that's super overpowered at its peak but is not really good 24/7. I prefer the consistency in Byron. I don't know about you guys, which is why I'm so interested to know, to see what you guys think. But that's going to be it for today's video, so I hope you guys enjoyed. Let me know if you're team Byron or team Edgar in the comment section below. That's going to be it for today. I will catch you guys again tomorrow. Peace.